beaming into your mind like a ray of cosmic revelation, smashing through the mainstream like a comet of prophecy. Lords and ladies, welcome to Planet Frolock, your show for everything super psionics, psychotronics, radionics, and magic tech. Tonight's podcast, Yellow Magic and Psionics Global Intelligence. Tonight I'm going to ask you a few questions to consider about where you believe we are at in terms of technology, artificial intelligence, and quantum computing. Then I am going to ask you where you would like to be in the days, weeks, months, and years ahead in all of this technological jungle of ideas intertwined with available information, and of course ask you to interpret this information so as to better conceive of how what we thought was impossible can be made into actual. So without further ado, let us begin. I would like to begin tonight's presentation with a quote from a brilliant mind, Mr. Oleg Feldgetcher, a 30-year AI practitioner, and this quote is from his book, AI Boogeyman, Dispelling Fake News About Job Losses, and I quote, "The promises of artificial intelligence are all around us, but you also see and hear a lot of hand-waving and imagine the future narratives." So basically, what I do is help separate the wheat from the chaff and share my 30-year wisdom to distinguish facts from fiction. End quote. All right, so you heard it. And there's much more to read in Mr. Feldgetcher's book, AI Boogeyman, Dispelling the Fake News About Job Losses. I am personally reading this book myself, and along with some back and forth cross-referencing in a number of books, including Kai-Fu Lee's AI Superpowers, a book about China's advancements in artificial intelligence, and other references, and so on. But what I find most inspiring and most sensical is Mr. Feldgetcher's explanation of how we will still need to have professionals interpreting the information that artificial intelligence provides. Not only interpreting, but working with that information. Real professionals, human beings. For example, data can be flagged by AI. But at the end of the equation, here we still need a professional human being, a professional of some kind interpreting the information that such systems will provide. In banking, we will continue to rely on human professionals to interpret data in regard to things like money crimes, such as fraud and money laundering, just to name a couple, for example. Well, I thought I'd throw this out for my listeners who are more interested in the future of technology and careers. And of course, if you are in the business of running a company, you might consider giving Mr. Oleg Feldgetcher a call for his expert advice concerning business models, artificial intelligence, and greater success. I plan to speak with Mr. Feldgetcher this coming month myself, so very confident to recommend him, as we have been talking via texting for some weeks now. And I look forward to a full consultation. All right, it's a real honor. So now go and do yourself a favor and call Mr. Feldgetcher for your business model advice, especially if you are interested in artificial intelligence or neural networks of any kind, size, or scope. All right, so let us move on to psionics and how the esoteric principles of magic might tie into the future of business, lifestyle, and your money. Very important to know what I'm about to share with you tonight, because frankly, I've had very big success in moving world affairs with psionics and bringing in new system that is going to make the difference between retrograding into a new dark age or heading into the future of positive prosperity. Like Mr. Feldgiger has been telling us about the crucial role humans need to play in artificial intelligence, so is psionics similar to this train of thought? Because, like most modern magicians and techno wizards, we realize today is that the human operator merely uses the machinery and gadgetry of psychotronics to do some of the heavy lifting, while the human operator is still the primary component to the entire system. This is true of anything we use in technology, even our smartphones, which help us keep organized and alert our attention to things of interest. We are becoming like cyborgs, but nothing like the hive mind concept in popular science fiction films, unless, as a matter of course, you take to heart the fake narratives of fake news, fake job losses, and so on, much to the point, right? Well, now I have covered the upside many times in my talks about business and money magic. Let me pull over for a moment to reflect on some disappointments so as to better realize what needs to be fixed. One area of dire importance is the customer service sector of business. I like the old saying that the receptionist is the face of a company, or at least in many cases that has been true in the past. We can also consider that a good or bad customer service experience makes or breaks a company, no matter how solid a product or their service is. For example, I recently used psionics to boost the student coin magically, and there is considerable coincidental success, but in the operation to increase interest. But I am not satisfied on the customer service end for a reason. Most recently, I was told that my inability to invest in STC coin is due to all the misinformation and payment agent relation or related something I didn't understand. The problem is that the simple explanation doesn't tell me a whole lot about the problem in my position there. And so, am I supposed to say it to myself, oh yes, misinformation, that's it, I understand. Well, of course not. I was given a form to fill out, a link, rather, to a form, but that form did not allow me to manually fill out anything information on my phone. And after clicking the submit button, only because the submit button was the only available button to click on that screen, I was redirected to a channel which appeared to be Telegram, full of various postings and interactions. So this did not solve or resolve my problem. And to date, I am unable to invest in the growing student coin, which is too bad. It is a cause that I think is good. But I will move on and use my magic to help other prospects, other businesses, who are going to give me an opportunity to invest in them while I use magic to help their business in the web of synchronicity and coincidental or incidental psychokinetics. I can do this, and I do this all the time. Some of you are probably familiar with my alternative pen name on Amazon, and you may have read my old book called The Yellow Magic Book, which is a book on intelligence magic. But if you have not read this book, don't worry. I plan to produce content which is much more modernly relevant to our contemporary times in my current work. But to the point here, what yellow magic can do in the right hands and with great aptitude, which comes from a practice knowledge, is to make coincidence more likely to produce desired breakthroughs in science and engineering, and business and products or services in general. Or as specific, we can be as specific as the psionics operator sees fit to work with. Now, my initial test of this yellow magic, though a rather outdated term now, I suppose, was with influencing new companies to rebuild retro video games into new releases on iOS and Android phones. My initial work, of course, began back in the late 1990s with online multiplayer games. I was working with telemechanics to see if I could read the minds of other players, which I was able to, on up through the 2000s. For all of this yellow magic projection work to come to fruition, to come together and reach fruition around the 2010s or so, 2010 maybe. What I saw as a result was great. And we saw the release of the game, for example, this is just one example, Sword of Fargo, which was a much-loved game I enjoyed as a child when I first played this game on my Commodore 64 computer. I think back now, I was probably somewhere around the age of 11 years old. And during that time period, I was also practicing coding in BASIC, a line-by-line programming pursuit from a booklet my stepfather had purchased for me to start learning about computer programming. Now, this might seem like a rather trivial retrospect on my part, but I assure my listeners that this initial engagement with computers was a key factor in my overall and continuous developing interest in the magic of computers and technology. For me, it began with, of course, our home telephone. When I was a child, I would take apart the telephone, the radio, and I even got into some trouble when I disassembled my stepdad's television set. Oh yeah, that was a really big no-no. But to correct my poor judgment of safety and perhaps inconsideration, my stepdad introduced me to hobby kits for building radios, crystal radios and TV sets, motor kits, and ultimately, my stepfather sat my young buddy down in front of a Commodore 64 computer, and he asked me to read the programming manual and practice familiarizing myself with the world of coding. I believe it was my natural talent for spotting where something wasn't working right, which piqued my stepfather's interest, as I enjoyed solving problems and I could detect on or off signals from electronic devices most intuitively with my aura and my mind's eye. So for me, all of this technology is rather personal, close to my heart, as they say. Alrighty then, let us now zoom out to take a higher bird's eye view where we are and where and what are the prospects for the modern world. I'm going to talk about another powerful name, and his name is Elon Musk. I think most people are aware, or at least familiar with, the work of SpaceX. And some closer followers of Elon's work may also be aware of this man's goal to make it to a spacefaring humanity possible and actual. And I do also believe or feel great excitement for SpaceX. However, here is something we may not have fully considered. There is another territory of Elon's work, and it is called Neuralink. Well, this technology is going to produce a device which will fit inside the cranium or bone of the head of a person and ultimately correct electric signals which in some or many individuals who suffer from pain or addictions, and essentially everything to do with the electrical signals in the brain. This is a huge, a colossal breakthrough in cybernetic medical technology, and it is going to change human life. I can imagine that at some point, even our human or individual perspectives of things like space-time might be augmentable via this cybernetic technology, Neuralink, Mr. Musk is working on right now. Will there be opposition to things like Neuralink? Well, I watched the videos. Neuralink is seemingly perhaps a less intrusive procedure of surgery in many ways. The operation could be done rather quickly prospect once perfected by Elon's team. But will there be competition? Maybe, and maybe not directly. What I foresee intuitively in my mind's eye is a future which exists in a state of tug-of-war between slick new chips and heavy old-school industrial things. The digital, moving forward ahead of the old industrial complex. But with magic, these distinctions can be smoothed out and blended harmoniously, thus ensuring that invested interests remain well-fed for their contributed efforts and the investors' money in. Some of the differences, getting back to the surgery, that I've looked at on video blogs propose new means for spinal surgery to correct disfigured or misaligned spines. These robotic surgery proposals are equally impressive to concepts like Neuralink, so I must keep watching and learning. While at the same time, working with dowsing and deep meditation, we should all be doing this, to view forward and then bring advances to near just around the corner. I do this. I enjoy this work. Let's see what else. Oh yes, IBM continues as a pioneer into quantum computing. As well, there is a great amount of effort that IBM has put into comprehension in terms of action in the form of content generation and even their own team and professional staff is making and has been making video documentaries, video introductions to their technology to explain to both the general public and possibly investors and other companies what quantum computing is, and introducing the IBM hybrid cloud. And of course, that's good business practice. Their content is very good. And well, that is just the tip of the iceberg, though. There's a link I'll provide in this podcast. It's for something, the prospect of the legendary med beds, which are said to work healing, but at the DNA level of a human being. I make no medical claims. I don't know. I just have a link if you're interested. Of course, we shall have to see if this is going to be an actual reality. And then if it is, if it does become that reality, will such medical technology be available to the average person? Or will it only be available to the super rich? Suggested projects. Well, as I've often said, the best thing anyone can do right now is learn about psionics, particularly my methods for constructing powerful psionic robots, tunable servitors, and my breakthroughs in psionic splicing. So I have two paperbacks for you that will help you there. If you are a beginner in psionics, then I urge you to read my book, Keep the Magic High. And that ebook is only $4.99 to get started learning about the magical lifestyle right now. And the distinction between terms such as psychotronics, radionics, and psionics or machine magic. Ready to take the first step? Start by downloading my multimedia package, Dynamic Dowsing Disclosure. This package includes audio lectures, a how-to dowsing video, and documents full of charts and pendulum construction instructions. The bare-bone basics of psionics, ladies and gentlemen, is based on the art of dowsing, so you need to learn this art form first. Therefore, download Dynamic Dowsing Disclosure. If you've been into magic for quite some time, but you haven't found perhaps the best manifestation tool, then you should purchase my Miraculous Prayer Board Mini Combo, which includes an operator's manual full of materials that are ordinarily reserved in secret for my closest club members and personal students. If you just want to get a spirit working on your behalf and get things, you know, jumpstart going right now with raw mental power magic, then look no further than my audiobooks. I have three of them. Fantastic Facilitators, Dynamic Defenders, and Magical Messengers. Combine these three, the Facilitators, Defenders, and Messengers, to secure all business transactions and assets magically. All you need is a computer to download the audiobooks and a pair of earphones so you can listen while you do the meditative and mental projection exercises to craft a spirit entity that will go into the future and work a smooth road of life ahead of you. Let's face it, the future is incredibly uncertain for most people today. Don't pass up this opportunity to learn from the first student of Charles Casimano, the godfather of psionics, yours truly, Herr Doktor von Vrilak. Yes, me. Well, this having been said, there are going to be some of you who need a professional magician to work on projects for you. My level of accuracy for getting results is rather excellent. Typically, the best of operators have at least a 15% failure rate. I think I go above this. But you'll need to fill out a form and wait to see if I can take your project, whatever it is. World events, protection of properties that you have invested in, or perhaps getting favor for your business service over another competitor or in a very tough arena, a narrow niche, I will consider all proposals evenly and across the board. Go to vrilak.com/contact. And then scroll down to the button displaying the words, Request Private Service. Click on that and get started filling out the form. I do not promise all projects will be taken, but I will read them. This concludes tonight's show, lords and ladies. And so thank you again for joining me tonight on Planet Vrilak Psionics Podcast. And until next time, as always, always keep the magic high. This is Herr Doktor von Vrilak, signing out.